Hey guys.
Hello.
What's up?
Hello.
Hello. Hello. I'll do it. I don't fucking care.
Oh damn, they're chatting already.
Yeah, they're a bunch of chatters.
Bunch of chatters.
Just chatting the night away.
Yep.
Chatting the night away. Hey, Milky Boy.
Oh, whoa, Milk is here.
Persephone Milk. Persephone Milk. Go. That's how he does it.
Was that a gay? Like, just a very exaggerated A sound?
No.
Professor Milk. Gay.
I didn't say gay, I said go.
Oh, is that how you said it?
Yeah, it's go.
You nailed that.
I have. Nailed I perfected it, Professor Milk.
Over years.
And I expect you to have one just as well when I next see you. All right, let's show them our stupid faces. What should we be doing when the cameras go live?
Do we have fixing our cameras.
Okay, yeah. All right, ready? All right, just waiting on Nasty here. Nasty, all right. Okay, here we go. And just adjusting this here. I think that's pretty good.
Go this way.
Wally's apparently on a tilt-a-whirl.
He's in a tornado.
Yep. What's up, everybody? Bee's lash? What's up, buddy?
Bee's knees.
Nighthawk, good to see you. Golgothas.
I gotta like fix this.
What's up, Pyro? Newest Patreon supporter, Pyro Gamer.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, I think he's on the ticker. I think I put him on the ticker.
I think you did.
Yeah. How's everybody doing? Everybody doing all right? Yeah. How are you guys?
I'm doing laundry. Good. Wally, yeah? You doing laundry?
Yeah, I'm doing laundry.
Oh yeah, you can hear it. You're both wearing red shirts, and me and Millpool are both wearing black shirts.
It's red versus black.
Red versus black. I'm wearing this time.
Stark Industries.
I'm
wearing a giant bomb shirt.
The difference between Batman and Iron Man is Stark.
Oh.
Yeah.
Like Tony Stark, the character?
Yes. Mm-hmm. That's the difference. One is Tony Stark and one is not.
The other is not. Nice.
That's the only difference, too.
Which commercial empire is more powerful? Wayne Enterprises or Stark Industries?
Stark Industries?
Yeah, Stark. Because fucking Wayne Enterprises is based out of Gotham, which is basically a fucking Detroit of the fucking DC world.
Right.
I thought it was New York. Is it not New York?
No, Metropolis is New York. I guess Gotham would probably be Chicago, office. Maybe.
Are they're both like technology companies?
I thought so. I mean, that's how he got all his Batman shit. They were
who
military
the fuck
subcontractor.
Knows what Wayne Industries does. He could have a fucking dildo factory for all we know.
Wayne dildos.
Baby Plant Daycare, good to see you, buddy. And I've got it.
Oh, I like tits.
I like meat and potatoes. Gotham isn't New York, fucking Golgothas. Get your shit straight.
He says it's in New York.
No, it's not. It's not New York. It's never been New York. Metropolis is New York.
Oh.
I always thought it was New York.
Hey, Omega. Good to see you, buddy.
Yeah.
I've been looking for you on Overwatch, but you haven't been playing much.
You haven't been around. I haven't been around.
Some have said that Gotham is also possibly Chicago, circa 1930s, but, you know, adapted over.
That's what I just said.
Or Chicago right now.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention to that part. I heard the Detroit rant. Like, it's like Detroit. It's garbage. And that's like, I just lost it from that point forward.
Well, I mean, it's not too far off.
I mean, it's run by a criminal underworld. It's a horrible city. I would move if I lived in Gotham.
Yeah, I would never want to live in Gotham.
Just because of Batman, I don't feel safe because of Batman. In fact, Batman's probably the problem.
Yeah, even in everybody comes there to
full
kill
of
him.
Supervillains.
Yeah, all
like
these other
a mile out of town.
Fucking cities like the Boise of the DC world probably doesn't have any problems because there's no goddamn Batman in Boise.
What are the major DC? It's like Coast City and Gotham, Metropolis.
Dick Starlight City.
Starlight City, that's the one I was thinking.
What else is there?
Those are the big three.
Where does Spider-Man live?
He lives in New York City.
Yeah, he's in New York.
Actual New York?
Yeah, yeah. Marvel all takes place in real world places.
Real cities?
Yeah, DC does not.
DCs are all knockoffs.
Batman is
mainly they didn't want a lawsuit. Batman doesn't fight fair either. He always needs some sort of gadget to give him the upper hand.
Yeah, but he doesn't use guns, so it kind of evens the playing field.
We're having this talk, are we?
He used to. His
he
parents
used
were killed
to?
By guns.
Yeah.
That's true. Yeah. Yeah.
Did
what do you call
Batman kill his parents?
Why didn't he become gunman?
So something? Let me get this straight. His
Well, bats his... didn't kill his parents.
No, but he's just like afraid
bats
of bats,
with guns.
Right?
No, he was, well, he was afraid of them momentarily.
That's the movie
He was inspired
bullshit.
By the fear.
Oh, yeah,
that's all I know.
Right. So I'm not reading that Gold with this. Why even post that shit? Nobody's gonna read that.
Yeah.
Oh, anyways, I was gonna ask. So Batman can shoot weapons out of his vehicle, but not with his own hands.
He actually shoots weapons out of his vehicle, like slingshots,
yep.
Get thrown at people, and
yeah, they just get thrown at people. That's how he uses guns. He throws
maces
them at people.
And flails and broadswords yeah. get shot out of his Batmobile.
Yeah.
Has he ever killed anyone?
Batman?
Plenty of people.
Really?
Sure. His history is so long and storied. I'm sure he's killed people.
I know that he like makes an effort not to.
Right. There's so many variations of Batman at this point. Like, which world Batman are we talking about? Fucking world. That's why I hate DC Comics. It's just all they do.
What's
is that? Everything that happens, anything major, they just cop it out with like. Oh, that happened. That really happened on another dimension of this world, because we live in this multiverse and we're on world
well,
one.
Well, I mean,
and
Marvel started doing that, but not until the 01 with Ultimates.
Well, Ultimates a total different reboot. It was there to cash grab in on new readers once.
Well, they also wanted to like unshackle the burden specifically of like the last 60 years.
Yeah, but they still went ahead with the regular canon. Like,
well, sure, they did, but I'm, you know,
Ultimate,
I was just of
yeah,
the multiple.
Ultimate was just like, oh, I saw the new X-Men movie. I'm going to go check out some comic books. Oh, I got to read fucking 80 years of
Well, I know, but I mean, books. That's still a separate branch of a tree that's split off, and then there's the movie.
But they're not, they never commingle.
Like, oh, no, okay, I see what you're saying. They're distinct as opposed to muddled like DC.
Yeah, Marvel, of course, has dimension stuff, but, like, DC's based around the dimension bullshit. Like, that's what they run on.
Yeah, they lean hard on it when they have to, like, retcon stuff.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we should probably get into the podcast.
Okay, okay. Damn,
podcast hasn't even started. You got another podcast to do.
Yeah, that's true.
So we got to get going. We got to get cracking. Plus, we got this guest here just waiting. How do you guys want to intro it? Fucking Nutri-Crane boy?
Let's chant fuck.
Fiber one. Gotta stay
Fiber
regular.
One. I like them poops.
He's a poopy boy.
Is that your boy toy?
Okay. So, what are we doing for an intro here? Hmm? Come on, guys. Put your thinking caps on.
I don't know, man. We had a super long one last week.
Yeah, do you want to do a really short one?
Yeah.
Okay, I got it then.
Okay.
All right. Let me get all this going. Does this work?
Yep.
Okay. All right, here we go. A 3, a 2, a 1. You're listening to Just Okay Gamers, where this week we're doing a podcast.
We're just okay and we played some games. We're just okay gamers.
That was a good one.
Yeah,
that was short. You said it would be short.
For those of you that want to know the backstory, you should show up and watch us live on twitch.tv/justokgamers every Thursday.
Jesus, Nasty. You're doing a plug at the start of the podcast?
Yep.
What is the matter with you?
Gotta get them before they tune in.
Yeah, before they leave.
They're falling quickly. After that lackluster intro.
What do you mean? That intro was perfect. It explained everything that's going to happen. And
it did.
You know? And then we got right into it.
That was a really quick podcast.
What if,
we
went
straight from intro to plugs.
If I'm listening to a podcast, I would think, you know what? These hosts need to quit fucking around and get to the goods, baby.
Yeah, we're fucking around is what we do best.
True, because we sure as fuck don't know anything.
No, we don't know a thing. We don't know a single thing about anything.
About anything thing.
Jon Snow?
Thanks for listening to episode 165.
165?
165 of the Just Okay Gamers podcast. My name is Guido, and I'm here with...
Wally.
Oh, it's a Millpool.
yo, it's Nasty.
What's up, guys?
Hi.
Hello.
Boy, we're two Thursdays in a row. We're doing well here.
Guys, we're back on track.
Yeah, we're back on track until next week.
This is going to...
We fell off the wagon.
Until next week? Okay.
Yeah. No, yeah. I'm back. I'm back, baby.
No, next week we got to do it on Tuesday.
Yeah, we got to do it Tuesday next week.
And I think the following week we have to do it on Tuesday. So, prep for that, live audience.
Yeah.
Did you guys do anything fun this week, huh? Do anything interesting or fun?
I got a wisdom tooth pulled. Wasn't fun.
Well, I guess that's a fairly big life event.
Just one?
Just my top one. My bottom two were already gone, so... I just pulled one.
Did they gas you up?
Nope.
Oh, local.
Really? They didn't even give me any good drugs.
Damn. Just yanked it out, huh?
It didn't hurt. Like, it was already on its way out. So.
Yeah, it didn't hurt.
No, not at all.
Oh.
Like, it felt better instantly when they pulled it out.
That must have been bad, then, if it actually was better.
It was, like, pushing on all my other teeth.
Mm.
So, it was pretty shitty.
Hmm. Yeah, I got all mine when I was, like, 16.
Push it.
Yeah? Push it real good.
Boom, ba da da boom, ba da 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 da. You got all your wisdom teeth pulled out at 16?
I think I was 16, yeah.
Hmm. When I had braces, they had to pull 4 of my teeth out, just regular teeth.
What? Yeah,
really?
I had like 9 pulled out before I got braces.
9?
Yeah. To get them to
like,
fit?
Because you had
like
9
extra teeth?
I think so. I think that was a number.
What are you, a shark?
What?
Maybe it was less, because that does sound like a lot.
That is a lot. It's
like he's got a second row of teeth just waiting to come in.
That's a lot. No way you got 9 pulled.
Yeah, it's probably not.
You should consult your records, your dental records, right now.
I have them right in front of me.
So. Yeah, so do
I. Okay, good. Yeah,
show it to
pull
us.
Them up. Yep, let's see. Yeah.
I'm not going to show you my personal information.
How many teeth do you currently have?
24.
24?
Wow. Is that normal?
I don't know. How many teeth does a human have? I thought it was like 32.
I thought it was 32 also.
I could 32. It is? Did you just Google it?
I did Google it.
Thanks. Good job.
I definitely thought it was 32. 24 sounded really low. Yeah. Because, like, think about it. You can see usually, like, 12 of people's teeth. Like,
for sure,
smile.
I had 24. I just did a rough count with my tongue.
Did a rough count with my tongue?
So you got eight pulled?
I can see eight on your top half. I can see eight on your top half.
You do have kind of a small mouth.
Yeah.
That's weird.
I guess. Put your teeth away.
Put them away, baby.
Put them away.
I guess I have 28 teeth because I had four pulled.
Oh.
Yeah. What? What's your favorite number? Do you guys have lucky numbers?
1952.
9.
13.
Oh. Mine is...
What's your favorite number?
1952-9-13.
Whoa. Weird.
Yeah, I know.
It's weird that you say it like that, too.
It's eerily creepy. Close to mine.
Yeah. It's really like 1,952,913.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. That's hard to format in my brain.
Well, it is your lucky number.
Yeah, yeah. I know. I just don't refer to
it
like that.
1952-913 is just a lot easier to say.
Totally. It's like a phone number. What?
Why that number?
Because that's the number of bitches I fucked.
Almost 200,000 girls?
No, it's over a million, buddy.
Yeah, almost 2 million girls.
Yeah.
How do you have time for anything else?
I don't.
He's constantly fucking. You're fucking right now. Yeah, camera can't pan down.
Oh, that's funny. I knew it.
Yep.
I guess when you got a dick that big, you can fit like 1,000 girls onto that once.
It's about efficiency.
It's probably just getting fucked and he doesn't even know it.
I just lube it up and then go on an incline and they slide down it. Yeah. They slide down it with their legs, you know, straddling it.
Just find a good vein and just coast.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Aren't you just riddled with STDs?
Yeah. Yeah. It's a horrible.
But when you got a dick that big, I guess you don't have to worry about it because you got other good surface area.
Yeah, but the good thing is that my dick, like, sheds its skin like a snake every several months.
Yeah, with its razor edges.
The good thing is that my dick.
Yeah, yeah. So it all comes out in the wash, you know.
No, I don't know.
Do you think Riot ever listens to our podcast?
No.
It's just like, these guys are League of Legends?
I mean, I think sometimes people from Riot listen, but not like a major, like I'd say maybe 1%.
Oh, we got fans at Riot.
1% of Riot?
Yeah, tops.
We got fans at Riot specifically, and that's why we can do anything, I think.
We can do anything.
Well, I mean, like, I was, how many times, I think I was walking around talking to random rioters and like, oh yeah, just okay gamers, come on in, you know, and like nobody else would know, but like a very strangely high percentage of Riot people knew who we were.
They just fucking put their fucking palms on the ground and spread
come
their cheeks
in.
Open.
Oh, they genuflected. One actually presented themselves. It was really awkward.
So they answered a Skype call?
Yeah, that's a big callback.
Wow. Wow, massive.
Yeah, it's been a while, I guess, since we've talked about that.
No, what's up? Shout out to our Riot listeners. We love you. You know who you are.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're very friendly, and they like us.
Yeah. I didn't do anything this week.
What?
Yeah, it's sad. Like, I I should really go grocery shopping. I didn't even do that.
You didn't do that?
I did it today.
Oh, I still have to get groceries. I haven't done it yet.
But I needed groceries for the past, like, several days.
Is that something we can talk about for our weeks?
No.
Because that would make my weeks a lot more interesting.
Yeah, what did you do then?
I could just talk about going, I went grocery shopping.
And?
Did
you find any
and
sick
what
deals?
Else, or what did I get?
And what else? No, and what else?
Let's see. We needed paper towels. We needed
sponges.
Oh,
no, not like, what did you get? Like, what else did you do?
I didn't I'm stalling for
Did
time.
Did you say you needed scrunchies?
Sponges.
Oh.
I feel like washing the
if,
dishes.
Yeah, you can tear through those if you wash dishes a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
You should get one of those things on the stick, like a sponge or like a brush on a stick.
Yeah.
What, like a toilet bowl cleaner?
Why should I do
that? But not you don't use it in the toilet bowl. Because they last longer than sponges.
Yeah, than the sponges because they stay dry.
Yeah, stay dry. You can really get in there and scrub pots and pans with them.
What are you talking about?
Or even like glasses. You can use them on glasses. It works really well.
They have like the wands that have the sponges on the end and you pour soap inside the handle.
Oh, okay.
I don't fuck with the soap in the handle bullshit.
No, but it's the same. You can do the soap in the handle or you don't have to. But it's a lot easier to do than just like a regular sponge.
Yeah.
Oh, we had to, I had to do some home repair. I felt like a real man.
Oh. This week. What'd you do?
Our dogs chewed up one of our baseboards. So we got some like putty and some paint and I repaired it.
Puttied it and repainted it?
Mm-hmm.
Nice job, Mel.
Well, I fucked it up the first time and it looked like shit. So I had to like scrape it all off, which was a huge pain in the ass.
Yeah.
But it looks pretty good now.
I don't do much home repairs.
Yeah, I always think, like, when I get a home, like, I'll become more manly, because I'll start doing, like, projects. No, it doesn't work like that.
Well, for Guido, it doesn't work that way.
What's that supposed to mean?
You don't have a basement, so, like, everything is on
It doesn't matter about my fucking basement or the non-existence of it.
I'm going to inquire now. Has the basement been a hot point between you two before?
It has. It has. Like, I told him I was getting a house.
4 years.
And I told him I was getting a house, and I was like, yeah, but it doesn't have a basement. And he gave me this look that I'll never fucking forget. He looked like half disgusted and half like he doesn't believe what I'm telling him.
You fucking scum.
I didn't believe you at first. I thought you were, like, fucking with me. Like, yeah, it doesn't have a basement. And I was like, what? No basement? This is Wisconsin. Like, basement's a necessity.
It's not a necessity, man.
I guess, as long as you got a closet to put everything in.
Are basements, they're a big thing, or what?
Yeah, like, every house here has a basement, for the most
part. Are they usually finished?
Not a lot in my neighborhood.
No, they're usually not finished. Usually they're, like, storage space that's underground, and it's a little bit warmer so, since it gets cold here, you know, so you have indoor storage.
Most of Guido's neighborhoods, like Victory Homes, though, like post-World War II, and they're usually basementless sometimes. That might be why.
Yeah, this is a post-war house given to the GIs when they returned home.
You know why you don't have a basement? It's because you got that weird configuration with the garage. Like that.
No.
I bet that's why they made that decision, because they're all there's the basement space right there.
It's right. Like, yeah. It's a big basement or a big
garage. You should dig your own basement.
You're right. Yeah. I have been money. Actually.
How's that going?
I do one shovelful a day.
That's not very much work.
Yeah, no, I don't like working on it.
Let's talk about anything but video games the entire podcast. We are on a fucking tear right now.
Oh, I love it. So speaking actually of grocery shopping, kind of going back.
Oh, we're launching back into grocery shopping.
Yeah, going back into grocery shopping.
There was the new
grocery store that opened up here in Milwaukee called Fresh Time.
Ooh.
Have you been?
We got one of those.
Yeah, you do.
No, I haven't been to the new grocery store.
Oh, you should go. It's really, really awesome. Cool.
Yeah. What makes them really cool? Do they have fucking slides and shit in them?
No. Really
it's a fucking grocery store. It's
really
not really cool. I've seen grocery
really
stores
deals.
Before. The coolest grocery store I've probably ever seen, like, you guys can't compare to it.
I'm going to chill with my grandpa now and be like, well, they're clean.
That's
the first thing he'd say.
That's a bonus.
But yeah. No, they're really nice. They look really nice. The guys
they're clean, and they don't have a lot of those colored people roaming around.
I just spent 3 years fighting Jeps.
I hope riot people aren't listening.
Well, no, I mean, that's what my grandpa would probably say.
That's their generation, yeah.
Yeah.
And then it's a no wonder why we didn't get all invited to go to the upcoming thing.
Yeah.
The skit we would have come up with would have been epic, I guarantee it.
It would have been.
Should we do video games? Yeah, probably we should launch back into the topic that we cover weekly. Instead of the hot new local grocery joint. You stopped the podcast to say that you found a hot new grocery joint.
It was a hot new grocery store. I had to tell you.
All right.
They are really good. You have to try it. They're nice.
Yeah. It's fucking it's gorgeous in there. It's gorgeous. Yes,
it's ridiculously gorgeous inside.
It's gorgeous. And there's underground parking in the basement.
Oh. La-di-da. All right. On to... League of Legends, here we go.
Bloody hell. We know. The silk suit hurries by as it catches the portal. No fool. His eyes, just for fun, he says, get a podcast.
That's just the way it is. All right. Okay, so we got a few things to talk about. The biggest one is probably the next class update, which just got kind of dropped today.
It was dropped today.
Who they're working on.
Who's that, Guido?
It's going to be the ass ends.
I love asses, especially when there's two.
Oh, double the asses, double the fun.
Ass to ass.
Ass to ass.
Some assassins are getting fixed. Who would this entail? Yeah.
This is going to entail Akali,
Kha'Zix,
Fizz,
Rengar,
Echo,
Katarina,
Zed,
Talon,
Shaco,
LeBlanc,
Rengar,
Kassadin. I said Rengar. Gotcha! Winner!
I forgot Evelynn.
Everyone does.
Yep. Evelynn needs a lot of these guys need help.
Yeah, they do. It's just assassins right now in the state of League are kind of forgotten. And they're turned into tanks most of the time when you see them.
Is that still a thing? The tanky?
Tank Echo, Tank Fizz is huge right now.
Yeah, those are still kind of big.
Oh, are they?
Not as big as they were. They got nerfed a little bit, but right. Yeah. You can still make it work. Thing.
Evelynn's probably the first on this list. For the least played, probably, right? Maybe, right?
She's Shaco? I'd say maybe Talon right now.
You think Talon?
Katarina. I see a lot of Talons. I mean, you see
a lot of Talons?
Yeah, I have.
Maybe Akali even.
Hey, I played League Katarina. Of Legends this week.
I did too.
Sweet. Wow, we're all on the same page. Wally.
Except for Wally. Who's going on another League of Legends podcast. Yeah.
Going on four wards.
Oh. Teaching people how to league.
Rivals. Teaching them how to talk about Warhammer.
Teach them how to get grocery stores.
Yeah. And grocery stores.
Yeah.
Warhammer has basically been the game I've been playing when I've had free time.
Nice. So, assassins.
I didn't read this. What are they
I don't know. Assassin damage needs to not happen literally in the blink of an eye.
Right.
So they need to stop being assassins.
Yeah. Doesn't make sense.
Right. No more.
Well, are they all going to have like tickers like Zed?
Well, what? Didn't they say something along the lines? I was actually reading it back when you linked it earlier. It's just like there's issues of fairness because of the instantaneous delivery of damage.
So I think the only issue is the one we mentioned, which is them not getting built as assassins when they get built as tanks. That's right. The issue.
Well, what they said is that they want to kind of make it so it becomes more of a skill shot type of thing. And I don't know if it's skill shots is what they're actually going to be doing, but they want it to be like, well, I should have played that better, not like,
well, the opposite.
Rengar jumped on me and now I'm fucking dead.
They want to give it like a skill shot for the person avoiding the attack.
No, they want to make it skillful assassins, not just like
mechanically
go invisible, jump on somebody and fucking destroy him in like three hits.
Providing opponents with a short window, even if it's brief.
Right, yeah. So, like, Rengar, you have that, like, second where when he goes out of invis and jumps, like, you can still get away. But you're probably not going to.
Yeah, you don't, especially Fed. All of these guys. Basically, right. Zed, if you get caught and you're unaware, then you're
fucked.
You're boned. Yeah.
But I think that they're right. This should be not like an all or nothing. But how do you balance that, though? You know, like, you got to make somebody strong enough in like the early game to be able to stick around, but not like overly powered in the late game that they blow somebody up instantly. I mean,
it's tough.
It is.
A lot of these have like, they do have point and click abilities, like Akali Echo, Fizz, Katarina. You know, they can all jump on you right away, so maybe they're just saying they're going to take that stuff away.
You think so?
Or put longer cooldown on it?
When opponents inevitably die from an assassin, they should be thinking, I could have done that better, rather than there was nothing I could do.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it gives them an out, essentially.
Yeah, looking at all of these champs, like, they all have either the point and click thing or a blank, like LeBlanc,
right.
Shaco, Talon, Zed,
Kha'Zix, Fizz.
They all have like, yeah, they all have a kind of big gap closers, yeah. Yeah, that are like blinks.
Jeez, all of them do, except yeah. Evelynn, but she's got her speed up.
She's got a speed boost, yeah.
Yeah.
And she's invis. I think that Eve needs, I don't know. Like, I think where she is right now for her invis is fine. I just don't think that she's strong enough to actually like compete with other damage dealing junglers right now.
You call her Eve for short?
Yeah.
But her full name's Evelynn?
Yeah.
So shouldn't you call her Ev?
Well, what's EVE?
Eve?
Yeah.
Yeah, but
I just dropped the Lynn.
You're short.
I mean, I could call her Lynn too for short if you want me to.
But you don't call her. But you don't call her Evelynn. You call her Evelynn.
No. Evelynn, yeah.
I think you're grasping at straws here.
Yeah.
I'm just clearing the air. I just want to know.
Where's the Evelynn? Where's that syllable come from?
Yeah, but you're dropping it. I mean, you're just shortening it.
This is kind of a chicken and the egg thing.
Yeah, it's Eve.
I mean, it's Ev or Eve, depending on how you want to follow the rules of grammar.
Nah,
it's Eve.
I mean, people don't call me fucking Pate.
Yeah, because there's no E at the end.
Why would they?
Yeah, because there's no E at the end.
Doesn't that support Nasty?
Yeah, it does.
Why?
Because
there's an E at the end.
Because they don't.
But the E doesn't matter if you're dropping the fucking thing.
Yeah, but according to your logic, people aren't calling you Pate. They're calling you Pat. So they're calling her Eve because they're dropping the rest of the name.
Right. They're dropping the Rick off of your name.
We're dropping the Lynn off
of Eve's name. Not every shortening of a name is the same.
I think every shortening
of that name.
Every shortening is the same.
Richard and Dick. Yep. Okay, Richard and Dick.
When you shorten Margaret, it's like Marg.
Yeah, right? Marg.
No, you don't say Marg.
Yeah, you do.
Who calls someone Marg?
I do, Marg. Man.
Get over here, Marg.
You guys don't know what you're talking about.
Margarita is what I think of when I hear Marg.
Just, you know, maybe work on your name game here, guys.
Give me a tall glass of Marg later.
We apologize.
Yeah, thanks. So, I think Ev really needs an update.
Oh, she's getting one. You're in luck.
Yeah, good. You're in luck. Eve's is getting an update.
Really good to hear. Really good to hear. Yeah. So
so is Michael trimmed down Mitch or Mike?
Mike.
Okay.
Right.
Just curious. Like, I've seen some people do Mitch for Michael, and I was wondering if that's kind of an aberrant thing.
No. People shorten Mitchell.
Mitchell.
Oh, it's Mitchell, yeah, but I saw someone named Michael shorten it down to M-I-C-H, and everyone will call me Mick. Mitch.
That'd or Mick, Mick,
yeah. It should be Mick, then, shouldn't it?
I'm glad we...
Yeah.
We went back onto it. We guys want to go back to grocery stores too?
Oh yeah, it's a marvelous grocery store. It's so clean.
It's great.
That's Tony the Tiger.
This group of people is like, if people blindly made a list of players that Guido has no interest in playing, this would probably 80% of these would probably fit on that list.
Yeah,
I don't like playing assassins.
You don't like being in people's faces.
No, I like.
You're
books.
Much more of a distant pokey player.
Well, that's not true because I like tanks.
Besides Zach. Yeah, unless they're tanky.
Yeah.
But you don't really have a choice if you're a tank.
The stick and get out, I don't really much care for, so. Do you guys like playing these people?
I do.
I'm looking at the list. I play, like, Zed, Fizz, pretty much those two.
I like Akali, Fizz, Kha'Zix, LeBlanc, Zed.
I actually like Cassidy.
Eve, if I can play Eve, but lately she sucks.
Yeah, so except you play him as, like, jungler support or ADC or some bullshit.
No.
Fucking asshole.
No. I play Fizz and LeBlanc mid. I play Kha'Zix in the jungle, Eve in the jungle, Akali top, and Zed mid.
Nope. Next time I play, watch.
You're wrong.
Next time I'm just going
now
after
I'm
Mike.
Play support.
I know. Next time I play with you, you'll be like, oh man, I've been playing Akali support. It's been going so good. So good. I'm going to play it this game too. and then you'll go and continue to just feed.
It's because it doesn't work with the champions that you play.
Oh yeah, blame it on me.
No,
sure. I'll take it. No, I'll take it. It's
it
my
doesn't
fault.
Work in
it's
a
my
comp,
fault.
And I need to recognize that it doesn't work in a poke comp. So we have two very different play styles.
Yeah,
Queens is sit back and he's like, don't go in. I wouldn't go in.
No, I do that. Fuck you. You know why I do that? Because I'm a smart goddamn player.
And then I die. And then I'm like, I shouldn't have gone in. I'm not disagreeing with you. Let me fucking finish it.
From the limited amount of time I've played with Guido, I will make the even-handed observation that 9 times out of 10, I die watching his ass running away from a situation. But every single time he ran away, it was technically warranted. He just makes a case of getting out of dodge and fuck everyone else.
Yeah, like, dude, I ain't dying.
Guys, let's hold on. I wasn't ready there. We shouldn't have gone in. And then he's like standing at the tower.
Hey, you know, if you guys played more like me, we'd win more often. I'm just saying. All right, that's enough for League of Legends. No, Nexus Siege. Yeah, Nexus Siege. Red Mercy did like a 30-minute. I didn't watch any of it.
Yeah, it was a good video. He talked about it a little bit. Actually, a lot of it. He played both sides. So basically, this is a attacking and defending team game. You have 20-minute countdown timer on each side, and they take half of the map away, and you can teleport in to mid. If you're the attacking team, and if you're the defending team, then you can teleport to your first turret. The outer turrets are gone, so all that you have is your inner turrets and your base turrets and then your Nexus turrets. And by base turrets, I mean inhib turrets. And the minions just continue to push like normal. There is no last hitting. It's kind of like in ARAM where you get accelerated XP and accelerated gold income. You can back whenever, though, unlike ARAM, and you can teleport back in whenever you want. And you don't have summoners. You buy modifications to your turret, and then you can use those.
Oh. So. Like
completely different game mode.
Yeah.
It feels like a little bit like, what the fuck is Blizzard's?
Demigod?
Heroes of the Storm.
Oh.
Where you don't really get rewarded for like last hitting, and it's just kind of like a team game.
That's fun.
You know,
I'll give it a shot.
Yeah, it seems kind of fun. I don't know about the whole turret augmentation stuff.
No?
Oh, I take that back. You do get rewarded for getting kills because that's how you buy the tokens for the turret augmentations.
Okay. Yeah, Demigod had a little thing like that, which is probably the first MOBA I've ever played.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I've watched people play it. I never played it myself.
Oh, it was so much fun. It just died because they didn't release champions with it. They had like
fair enough.
8 champions. But yeah, you would progress your base and your towers and stuff with the money that you got from kills. This is an interesting game. It was pretty fun.
That's the thing, though, is that these augmentations are not permanent.
Oh, no?
So, no, they're consumables. So you can use your augmentation on the turret, and then somebody else can use the same one after you. But some of them have, like, cooldowns on the turret. So you can put the turret in, like, a stasis mode, so it get, like, bard ulted, and then it does AoE damage around it, and then it goes, I think, into like a 10 second or 15 second cooldown before you can somebody else can cast that again on that turret.
The one I saw was the attacking team can buy like siege minions, and they stand like really far back from the turret and just like launch projectiles at it.
Like Baron siege minions?
No, they're
stationary.
They're right? Like they're regular siege minions. They just are further back.
Oh, they also have another one too, where you can like put down stationary turrets, and you can't kill them with abilities. You have to auto attack them. So, the stationary turrets you have to auto attack.
How are these people getting access to this? Is it on the PBE?
It's on the PBE.
Yep. Oh, it is.
Yep.
I'm surprised I haven't heard more about it.
It just came out this week.
Yeah, this week. Still a long time. A
couple
time.
Days ago. A few days. 2 days ago.
I didn't see much on Reddit or anything.
Yeah.
Or like Twitter.
I told you about it like a week or two ago.
I don't think anyone's mentioned it to me.
No, that was specifically remember.
I said, weren't hey, they Guido. Also teasing at like bringing Dominion back, kind of like a Dominion map with another siege they called it, type like, thing?
Not Dominion or something. Definitely not Dominion.
Oh, was that like a joke?
So no, it's I think it's a real thing. Yeah, I don't know when that's coming. For some reason, I already thought it came and went, because I think some of the pros were playing it at some event.
Oh, were they? It might have been one of those rotational ones that I didn't really pay attention to. Like, Hexakill came and went, and I didn't even notice
it.
And All for One came and went, and I didn't even notice it.
Yeah, I don't think it's been out yet.
Well, I will try it. I probably
you don't like any of
won't
the
like it.
Game modes, though.
Yeah,
what's
you,
your favorite?
You like League for League.
I like Doombots.
Yeah, I want them to bring Doombots.
I heard they're not coming back, though.
No. I like Doombots because it was like no one gave a shit. It didn't
not
turn competitive. Already. Yeah.
Right.
So.
And it was best like, when no one gives a shit.
It was the first like PvE style League game. You know, where it was right. Like you against the world or against like the environment.
Yeah, it's co-op instead of competitive.
Right, and that's what I liked about it.
No, Millpool, you against the world.
Yeah, you against the world.
Including my parents?
Everybody.
Oh, yep. Everyone, yeah.
Whoa.
Fucking Ronald McDonald.
Dalai
Lama.
And Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton, people that use dollies in their jobs.
Yeah.
Anyone that's ever owned a dolly, like a doll.
The inventor of the dolly?
The yeah. American dolls?
Yeah, American. The whole line of American dolls.
Yep. And American Eagle.
You against all
fuck American
people.
Eagle.
The Goo Goo dolls?
Yep.
Fuck Goo Goo Eagle dolls. Cars?
Fuck the Eagles, the band.
Fuck the Eagles band?
Yeah, fuck
bands in general.
Yeah, Dave Matthews Band.
Dave Matthews Band.
Yeah.
Fuck Dave from KFC.
Yep.
Average or, white band.
Wendy's, sorry, Wendy's.
Yep. Fuck chickens.
Fuck chickens.
Fuck eggs.
Fuck Chick-fil-A.
Fuck Chick-fil-A.
Fuck fillets of fish.
Band, I wonder.
It's you against all these people and things.
all these things.
Yep. Yep.
But those they're not bringing it back.
I'm glad we just listed all these things that are in the world.
I was just trying to do the
grocery stores.
I was
anyone
just
named
to do
Eve?
The word thing.
I was just trying to do the word thing. So there's this video, DreamHack. Did you guys go to DreamHack?
No, I wanted to. I really
yeah,
wish
I suppose
I've been
I did
able
too.
To see the cosplay section.
Right. Yeah, League of Legends. There's a League of Legends cosplay thing.
I must say I was inspired by the cosplay that happened at PAX and the booth that was put on there, or like the thing that was put on by Spazzy. So
yeah,
that's why I wanted to go see this one here at DreamHack.
You're making your own cosplay?
Mm-hmm.
Who are you going to cosplay as?
Nasty.
Okay.
Everything got really weird.
It's yeah. not cosplay rips.
Yeah, it's not.
No, it's not.
You saw no, you the whole thing.
Cosplay yourself.
Right. Yeah.
I thought those people were just cosplaying themselves.
Oh, yeah. You really thought there was a giant bird in Nivea on the stage?
Yeah. Her okay. mouth moved when she talked.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And you guys side with him on the whole Eve Ev thing? The guy who thinks cosplayers are real?
Shut up, Quino. Next thing you know, you're going to tell me Santa's not real, too.
No, Santa's definitely real.
Okay. Whew.
Yeah.
Don't take that from him.
He brings you presents. Presence of mind. So yeah, this cosplay thing at DreamHack was a travesty. If you guys haven't seen, just watch like the first 30 seconds and you'll understand. Is
this, I didn't watch this. I saw it. Is it worth
it looks,
watching?
It's
worth no, if you like if you like watching people cringe. Fail at things, then yeah. Like the but cosplayers did all did awesome. It was mostly the
yeah.
hosts.
It's
yeah,
not, I mean, it yeah, looks okay. It's not the cosplayer's fault. It's the host's fault.
Oh, okay, because I have the audio off. I'm like, I don't see anything wrong. Okay.
No, the hosts were just so awkward, and it seemed like it was literally their first time hosting anything in the world. Because they were just like, so, I see you have tails. No shit, she's fucking Ari.
Yeah.
How'd you make those tails?
All valid questions.
Sounds awful.
But it was also coupled with it being like a cosplay event. So like they're asking these horrible, horrible questions while people are dressed in these costumes and like doing these Mortal Kombat like kind of jiggly poses. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
It wasn't even like a pose from the game. It was just literally like standing and like over Tourette's, you know, like just like large movements.
So, yeah, just I wanted to mention it because it was funny. If you can power through it, it's funny to watch. Just search the DreamHack League of Legends cosplay show or whatever.
Yeah.
You guys want to talk about some LCS?
I would like to. Mel, right. Did you watch any this week?
I did, yeah.
Sweet.
I was thinking of doing like an LCS recap video, but then I realized I got through like one series. And it took me like an hour or something to make notes about everything. I'm like, oh, there's
forever.
Only 27 more games to get through. I'm yeah. not going to do this.
There's a lot of games now. I can't even keep up with EU because of the number of games that there are in NA now.
Yeah. If I don't have fantasy players in EU, like, I don't really care.
It's right. almost getting to like basketball or baseball proportions where you just got to find a team that you really enjoy and stick to it and watch them, you know?
That's not in the dots.
That's pretty much what I do.
Yeah.
I mean, If like TSM or C9 is playing, then I'm watching their games.
Okay. Those are your faves?
Yep. Top two. C9 is my favorite, but TSM's doing so well this season.
Speaking of?
Basketball. An article just came out that said that the LCS finals, like the World Championship, had more viewers than the NBA finals this year. So We're making waves, boys.
I thought that was every year. I thought we always got more viewers than.
No, I think
big
this
sports.
Is, this is the first year I think though that no, not the Super Bowl still is above. What LCS got, and I think last year the NBA Finals just barely beat out the LCS, but this year the World Championship took over.
Hmm.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Beating basketball. I don't like basketball.
It's a boring sport, if you ask me. People just run back and forth. It's like watching golf.
Well, I was kind of happy about the turn of events, basketball-wise.
Yeah, I was happy with the Cavs won.
Yeah. I mean,
well, Wally, you're a bandwagoner.
I'm from fucking Ohio.
Yeah, but still, you're a bandwagoner, right?
No, I've been a fan of Cleveland sports since I was born, practically. Mm, I'm from Toledo, for Christ's sake.
I don't buy it.
Sure. Anyways, back to LCS. So this weekend.
Yeah. Wally's a big basketball fan, guys. He's a huge basketball fan.
I'm a huge Cleveland sports fan.
Mm, nah.
There's the difference, Guido. No.
There's like a running theme this entire episode is Guido. No, I choose not to believe it.
What?
Favorite game, Mill, this weekend?
Yeah, let's see.
If you had to pick a series, I guess, for somebody to go watch, what would it be?
I forget. CLG MV, I think, was a good series.
Yep, the last game of the night or of the weekend. Great series.
And who else played? I can't remember. TSM and C9? No.
TSM and Envy played. TSM beat Envy. And C9 was also a good one.
I really like the Renegades versus Energy game. Yeah.
What? The Renegades aren't a team anymore.
Oh, yeah, not?
No.
Is Energy?
Yeah, Energy.
Yeah,
Energy
I tried to go for two teams that weren't played.
All the teams play.
Oh, all the teams play.
Yeah, every week. Yeah,
no, I meant to go with two teams that weren't in the LCS. Oh, well.
Oh, you're
shows
so funny.
How much I know. I couldn't even get the joke right.
Yeah, on good one.
Well, are you guys done with this?
Yep.
No, wait.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, Cloud9 Immortals, right?
No, C9 played TSM.
Oh.
That was the first series.
Yep.
And then
also a good game.
Yeah, okay. So that was a good series, and CLG Envy.
Yep. Envy's doing good. They're 5-1. Immortals is 5-1. TSM is 6-0.
Yeah. There was also a video this week that Monte Cristo put out about how scoring in the league is kind of bullshit because these teams play so many games, but they're only ranked in the league based on their series wins. So, like, if two teams are tied in the league, they're not actually tied because one team might have more game wins than the other.
Yeah, well, that's how it is. They do it on wins. So just because you have series win the same, if it comes down at the end of the split and two teams are tied, then it goes to the number of game wins.
Yeah. But if they have the same number of game wins, then it goes to the tiebreaker between those two teams, I think.
Right. Yep.
Anyways,
so like the series that they played, however many, whoever won the most of those. Is how it goes.
All right, we don't have to talk about this anymore.
Yeah.
No, well, I mean...
There's so much league to watch. Like, it's kind of hard to talk about the game.
Does Monte Cristo ever make anything or comment on anything that's not him, like, bitching or calling
bitching?
Out shit?
No. He's been bitching since you fucking met him 4 years ago about how shitty league's gonna be, yet he's still stuck with it for 4 years.
Yeah. Okay. That's it. You guys happy with that?
I think so.
Yeah, we can move on.
All right, let's
check it out for yourself. There's a lot of VODs.
A lot of odds? Oh, VODs. VODs.
Like fucking 30 hours of VODs. I spend all week Monday through Wednesday just listening to VODs at
VODs
work
are fun.
To try to like get caught back up.
All right. Well, let's get on out of league.
Segway.
All right, so our guest has been patiently sitting here. We have a guest here. We didn't even mention that.
Oh, we didn't.
So sorry. Sorry, guest. He's shaking his head. He's like, it's fine. His name's Dr. Richard Plunkett.
Dr. Richard Plunkett.
He reached out to us via electronic mail.
Hold on, let me Google him.
Some would call that email.
Yes. And asked to come on the podcast because he's got something that he needs our help with.
Hmm, okay.
So I guess...
We don't actually know this, by the way, to everybody listening. Myself, Wally, and Millpool haven't read this email. So you guys are hearing this first time that we're hearing it as well.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, I guess we'll just hand it over to him and see how it goes with all this. So I guess everybody welcome Dr. Richard Plunkett.
Hello.
Yes, hello, hello.
Dr. Richard Plunkett, how are you doing this evening?
Yes, hello, thank you. Hey, Richie. No, please, do not call me Richie, please.
Can I call you Plunky?
You may call me Plunky. In fact, I encourage you call me Plunky.
Dr. Plunky, huh?
Dr. Plunky is what my wards call me.
What's your doctorate in?
I'll get to that later. I mean, I haven't even properly introduced myself.
Dr. Plunky, I got a question for you before you introduce yourself.
Sure.
Do you, by chance, like the game Plinko?
Oh, I'm actually the half inventor of the game Plinko.
Oh.
How do you half invent something?
Me and my, friend, my good inventor friend, his name is,
James Naismith.
Dr. Pritchett?
Dr. Pritchett and Dr. Plunkett.
Yeah, oh, so that's how we got Plinkett.
Makes sense. Makes sense.
We put our foreheads together and we thought real hard on how to create a game.
Do you call your penis your forehead?
No, I call my penis Plinkett.
I thought that was the game.
Exactly.
Whoa.
And am I right in seeing that your company name is called PPLTD?
Yes, Plinkett and Plunkett, LTD, Limited Disposal Entertainment.
Oh, Disposal Entertainment.
Yes, it's disposable into games.
Oh, like one-use games?
Yes,
like...
you bring them out of the packaging, you set them up, you play them one round, and then they fall apart.
Huh. Wait, so like you make shitty, cheap games?
Yes.
Like physical games.
Yeah, that's one part of what I do with myself in my free time.
Yeah.
Okay. So what do you work
in fact, well, I'm Dr. Richard Plunkett, as has been stated.
Yes, thank you, Plunky.
And I am a philanthropist, and I guess some would say an eccentric millionaire. You know, I use my vast fortunes to travel the world and figure out life's mysteries, like mysterious happenings that go on in the world.
Okay.
I fly across the seven seas on my private jet and... find out the clues to these mysteries.
What kind of mysteries is
very
that?
Very interesting.
Well, I wanted to come on to your podcast, your show here, because of, I have a substantial amount of money, and I hear you have a substantial amount of viewers, like millions of viewers.
Well, yeah, we do.
Billions of them.
Yeah. Reaching that almost billion mark.
A billion movies?
Movies?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm not familiar with that word.
What is movies?
That's what he calls
movies. Movies are what I call viewers, yes. Viewers and listeners, it's a combination. A combination of the two.
Oh, I see.
Movies.
Gotcha. I haven't looked at the numbers recently, but we have quite a few. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I came onto your podcast to see if I could use your audience to figure out the latest mystery I've been working on.
What's that?
Well, you see, it is a mystery that has plagued mankind for ages. One that we will soon find out with the help of your movies.
Okay.
Which is your viewers and your listeners.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Got it.
With the help of them. And that is, maybe, if someone could please, we could come together and figure out where it is that these small babies come from.
Small babies?
Yes, where are babies born and coming from?
I'm sorry, Dr. Plunkett, where did you get your degree from?
I got my degree from Harvard, of course. Harvard Medical College.
Ma Harvard?
Ma Harvard?
Yes, Ma Harvard.
Where's Maharvard?
Well, it's in Hawaii. It's you say Mahalo and you say Maharvard.
Oh, okay.
But it's a well-regarded school, I do say.
That's weird. I've never heard of it.
Well, that's fine. I've never heard of you, you piece of shit.
Dr. Plunkett?
No. Dr. Plunkett, I was not...
Sorry, I have my temper. I have a temper.
Okay, thank you.
Could you give us a second, Dr. Plunkett? Could you take your headphones off for a second? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, by all means, I will take my headphones off.
All right.
Is this guy really a doctor?
Yeah, what should we do here? I think he's maybe going to give us a lot of money, but... I don't think he should be singing that.
This is his birthday.
We take the money.
This is his birthday. But all he wants to know is where babies come from.
Well, somebody tell him.
Yeah, but if we tell him, we might not get money from him.
Wait, are we going to give him the stork answer?
Yeah, let's do the stork.
Stork cancer?
Yeah, I'm okay with telling him that babies are dropped off by storks.
Let's give him stork cancer.
Okay, let's give him cancer. Dr. Plunkett?
Yes.
No, wait, weird. Hey. Did you hear us that whole time?
No, this fat fella here, he signaled me to come over back to the microphones.
Yeah, Guido.
Yes.
Is it your birthday, by the way?
Why, yes. How did you know?
Well, it's weird. You were just singing happy birthday to yourself.
Yes, I do that, even when it's not my birthday, but today it so happens to be my birthday.
Well, happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Did you know?
So, back to my question. Like,
where were you born?
I born? This notion escapes
me. The day
me.
Of birth.
Birth? I don't understand.
That's what okay. That's what we're here for.
Okay, yes.
Right? Oh. That's what you
so
want.
So you know the answer to this?
No.
Sure do.
No, but Nasty knows.
Nasty's got the answer.
Yep.
Tell him, Nasty.
So you see, out on Mahalo Island in Hawaii.
Mahalo Island, I'm well familiar with this island.
Okay, there exists a large nest.
A nest?
At the top of peak... Or the top peak of Mount Kilimanjaro.
Hold on, let me write this down. Okay, you understand I schooled in the islands of Hawaii, so I'm familiar with all this.
Have you been to Mount Kilimanjaro?
I climb it every other week.
Okay, perfect. So you know this large nest that I'm talking about.
I've seen this nest. It looks like a hobo's den of some sort.
Yeah, very large, right? Very, very large.
Very large. It's like a some sort of giant bird nesting area.
Bird
correct.
Hobos.
So, have you all seen all the birds coming and going from this giant nest?
Well, I mean, I don't watch them like masturbate or anything. But
No. I'm not talking about that. But you've seen them. They fly.
Oh, you said
out
birds coming.
Yeah.
Wait, can I interject before we...
Yes, please.
Okay.
Dr. Richard Plunkett is my name.
Right, Dr. Richard Plunkett.
Yes.
I feel like... I mean, you chose us for a reason, right?
Because of your vast audience.
Right, and we're helping you... figure out this
I've
answer.
Spent $7 million on this question.
How did you spend that much money?
Doing so much research... Money.
What kind of research?
I've been asking people. I go up to random people and I say, I'll give you $5 if you tell me where it is that babies come from.
And no one's had the answer yet.
Everybody just waves me away like there's some sort of conspiracy.
Conspiracy?
Mm-hmm. So there is a monetary reward, though? That's what I'm trying to get at here.
There is a monetary reward, yes.
Okay, because despite our vast audience of mirrors, is that what you call them?
Mirrors.
Mirrors. Sorry, can you repeat?
It's mirrors.
Right, despite our vast audience, I mean, we could use the money. That's what I'm trying to say.
Well, you know, I don't give handouts. So, like...
Yeah, but we're going to give you the answer to the question that you want to know.
Oh, okay, yes, please. I'm a doctor, and I've done so much doctor research on this.
All right, and all we ask is
all you need to do is
your millions.
Yes. Can you just please write a check out to Guido really quick?
Yes, I could do that.
Okay.
Awesome.
Right, perfect.
Okay.
Can
Guido.
Yeah.
Perfect. That's his given name, right?
Given name, yeah.
That's his Christian name, yes.
Okay. And I will give an undisclosed sum.
Wait. Okay.
Wait.
Yeah, give that to Gweeds. Yeah. Get him to look it over. Yeah.
Hey, are we good?
How's that check look? Well,
it just says undisclosed sum.
It didn't write an actual.
You didn't even write a sum on it?
I don't think that's legal.
No, of course I don't write that. I need the answer first before you get. Come on, please.
All right. Just
look, I don't know why you guys know this answer.
I'll give you the answer. Okay.
I was hoping that your audience would be able to reach out to me and give me an answer, but lo and behold, you gentlemen have this answer for me. One of life's greatest mysteries shall be solved right here. This is a huge moment in humanity.
Without our fans, I would not have this answer, though.
Okay, please.
So, at the top of the mountain, the bird's nest?
Yes.
Has a bunch of storks. In it. Have you seen the storks before?
I've heard this story before, and I don't buy it one bit.
What story?
The story of the stork. You're trying to swindle me out of my vast fortune.
The stork answer.
I'm trying to give you some stork answer.
This is not the true answer. I've known. Trust me, I'm a doctor. I've done my research.
Well, I can actually tell you where they come from. It's okay. There's a new grocery store in town.
Oh, is it Fresh Mart?
Yes, it's so clean in there.
Have you visited it?
I have been there.
If you go there to Fresh Time and ask the manager?
Yes, Fresh Time. Yes, I have.
He holds the answer to the world.
No. We know it.
Okay, we know
it. Your millions. We know the answer. I mean, please. I don't, but our viewers know.
Quit fucking bullshitting me and give me the goddamn answer, really.
So,
like, I just feel like you're trying to get my money.
Well, Dr.
Well, you
Plunkett,
came all this. You spent all this money already. Right. We just want to help you out.
Right. Dr. Plunkett.
Yes, I'm a doctor.
Are you available on social media?
Yes, I am available. I believe. What is social media?
Where could our viewers, our viewers,
yes.
viewers, be able to get in touch with you with the answer?
They can reach out to me at Dr. Plunkett, MD, at realhospitaladdress.com.
Realhospitaladdress.com.
Yes.
Could you put Guido back on?
Yes. Yeah. All right. You want him on, or you just want me to take the headphones off?
No, we want Guido.
Yeah, fuck off.
Okay. Yeah, they want to talk to you.
Okay.
Hey, guys.
Guido, what's your opinion of this guy?
Ah, he's great. He smells like hickory.
I don't know what to think of him.
He doesn't seem like a real doctor, though.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, I don't know what he's a doctor of.
Clearly, he doesn't know where babies come from.
He does not. No, he's spent lots of money. He has a briefcase.
This question plagues him.
He has a briefcase full of money that says "Where Babies Come From" fund.
Oh, well, just get the briefcase.
Yeah, just grab the briefcase and kick him out.
Yeah. Well, no. Yeah. I feel it's a simple answer. I don't know why you guys haven't just told him.
We should tell him the real answer.
I just don't want to give him a real answer. I feel like it's better just not.
I'd be curious to know what he's a doctor of too. You know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I tried asking him that. Seems he like just kept beating around the bush.
Something we should have asked him already.
Hmm.
Okay. I asked him where he went to school, and I was going to ask him where he studied, but it doesn't sound like a real school to me.
I think I don't know. Well, I'll let you guys wrap this up, huh?
Yeah. Get him back on.
Okay.
Hey, they want you back.
Oh, okay, yeah. Hello.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
Thank you. Welcome back. I just pooped in the bathroom.
That was quick. That was a fast. Congratulations.
Poop. Yes. It was good.
Okay, so we have the real answer for you.
Oh, yes, I'm a doctor.
Where do babies come from?
Yes.
Yes, but before we get into this.
Yes.
You never really stated what your doctorate was in.
Oh, well, I'm an obstetrician.
What the fuck?
Also a gynecologist.
Jeez. So you deliver babies?
Yes. I've never actually seen one, though.
How does that work?
There's a
keep
sheet.
Your eyes closed? Or?
There's a sheet between me and the vagina, the pussy. The medical term is pussy.
The technical term.
You've never seen a vagina or a baby?
I've never seen either.
Okay. So you know where they come from.
No.
Do you just want pictures of vaginas?
No.
We can get you some. I'm sure Guido's got some porn on the TV, the multiple TVs that he has in his living room right now.
Yes, I've noticed he's got quite the collection of copulating individuals.
Mm-hmm. Do you know what that is, what they're doing?
No. Okay. It seems they get naked and they hug vigorously.
Yeah, that's.
And sometimes they kiss the privates.
Yep.
Do you know what a penis is?
Yes.
Right, you have one? You have a penis?
I have four of them.
Okay. You have four of them?
Yeah, it's a small dog, right?
No.
No, the thing between your legs.
It's
that
like
you pee out of?
Yeah, where do you pee out of?
Oh, my robot dick.
Okay.
Yes, now I know. My robot dick that I was had a fixed.
Robot dick.
I had a fixed on me as a small age after my regular pee-pee was bitten off by a Rottweiler. So are you going to tell me or not? I can get the fuck out of here.
I don't know what to tell you anymore.
So men have penises. And ooh. When a man and a woman love each other very much,
yes.
Man's penis gets hard. And then it goes in the woman's vagina.
Oh.
And then it goes in and out until he ejaculates.
Yes.
He ejaculates sperm, and then the sperm impregnates the egg, the
yes.
woman's egg, and then the baby grows from there inside the woman's uterus. And then the woman gives birth to the baby, which
you
is
know the
what
rest.
You do for a living.
Wait, so you're telling me that all you have to do is my namesake? Dick Plunkett?
Bring it at home.
This is the whole thing.
That was one giant setup. Holy fuck.
Okay, I gotta go. I'll give you $1 million each.
Thank you.
All right, thanks.
It's like a laughing skit.
Dr. Plunky.
Yes, farewell, and thank you for coming on the show. Maybe I could come on once again once I have another mystery that needs to be solved.
Please do. Please come back and bring another $1 million.
Okay, please. I'll bring 10.
No.
Write real numbers on the checks, please. Don't
yes,
just write
undisclosed amounts. Or what?
No, you have about. To write the actual number.
Okay. Bye.
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 Yeah, thanks.
What's up, guys?
I don't think we're getting our money.
I feel like we're not.
I got a briefcase of cash right here.
Oh, perfect.
Oh, wow.
I don't know that I care about that.
What are you going to do with that?
Let me just open it up. Oh, it's just a wad of coupons for Dairy Queen Blizzards.
Oh, perfect. Oh, it's better than nothing. I love Blizzards.
It's 10% off a Blizzard.
Are they still valid?
Can I stack them? Can I use more than one?
Half of them.
Can I use 10
valid.
Of them?
Yeah, you can.
Yes, I got like.
It actually says on them that. Can be stacked.
Can be stacked.
Is he gone? Or?
He is just like walking in circles, and he's picking up his hat off the coat rack, putting it on his head, walking in another circle and putting the hat back on the coat rack. And he's done that probably about 17 times now.
I think you might need to let him in.
Yeah?
I don't know how a door works.
Yeah.
Did you let him in by chance?
No, he was here when I got home, just sitting on my couch.
That's weird.
Hands on knees, staring forward.
Wow, really weird.
He'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Reminds me of that, like, nanny, like the English nanny from that TV show. The Nanny.
The Nanny? Yep. Fran Drescher.
Yep.
Fran Drescher? I hardly know her.
I think she's attractive.
You do?
What? 90s? 90s Fran Drescher, yeah.
Adam Morelli, will you suck my cunt?
Fran Drescher. I thought you'd never ask.
Adam Morelli, fuck my vagina off, please.
Oh, God, yes.
Oh. Fuck. No, thank you. Ah, boy. All right, what do you guys... That was a fun guest.
He was a fun guest.
Yeah, went a little long, though. You know, you guys weren't getting to the point. But maybe we can have him on next time. Be more brief. We'll see if he gets another mystery or something.
Yeah.
All right, let's move on to general gaming. Yeah. All right.
And his name is John
Guido.
If someone gifted you guys a Segway, would you ride it around?
No. Get the fuck out of here, Segway.
How much are we paying for that?
We rent it. Alrighty. General Gaming.
So, summer Steam sale?
Yep, there's a summer Steam sale going on. You guys, I guess, I don't know. We're not going to go over all the deals.
I'm not looking forward to any of this.
Is there any game?
The deals, one by one.
Yeah, I got one right now I want to get.
What?
Banner Saga 2, and day one ends up on sale.
Yeah.
That's nice.
I kind of saw that one coming.
Do they still do the like daily deals and hourly deals and stuff like that? I didn't see
any. I haven't seen any daily or hourly deals.
Is there anything you've been waiting, like, or I'll pick it up during a summer sale?
Absolutely none, really.
No?
No, I already have too many games that I don't fucking play.
I'm sure there's something.
Dead by Daylight I'd probably pick up.
Did you buy that Jackbox Party Pack?
I don't know which one I have.
Because 2 is on sale for 65% off right now.
What does that include?
That includes... I can't figure out which
good
ones
stuff.
It is. I can like see them, but it doesn't have a list of like the ones that are included.
Oh, yeah, I'd probably get Dead by Daylight if it went on sale for a substantial amount. A lot of people are... picking up that game. It looks good. It's an asymmetrical kind of like evolve kind of thing. Well, actually, you don't fight back. So it's just like four people run from a monster.
It's hot right now. I don't know if it's going to get discounted that much.
Yeah. I'd probably rather just wait for the Friday the 13th game, which looks pretty cool. And it's an IP that I'm familiar with.
I've been watching streams of Dead by Daylight.
Dead by Daylight?
Yep.
And it's good. It's just like, okay. I mean, you're survivors. Guy's going to try to kill you. There's shit you got to turn on.
Unless there was like a hardcore group, I don't see much replayability out of it over more than like a night or two. So I wouldn't pick it up if it was more than $7. You know?
Yeah.
But
you don't think it's going to stick around? Like Left 4 Dead?
No.
Where you keep going back to it, no?
No, I haven't gone back to Left 4 Dead in a long time.
Yeah, but that's a night or two.
Yeah, that's true. I could play some Left 4 Dead right now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I
just stop the podcast, play some Left 4 Dead?
I want to go back to like Rust or something.
Yeah, I don't think we're ever going to get that again.
That was I thought that was going to be the new game of the month. We're not doing that anymore. But
no, we're not doing that anymore. It is on sale for $10, so if you haven't played it. Although it's a totally different game than when we played it. One it that I have no interest in.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, it's way too in-depth now. Lightning in a bottle.
Right.
For 1 minute.
Yeah.
I considered picking up Orcs Must Die just because it's $3.
I have the sequel, which I believe is co-op, if anybody ever wanted to do that.
I have two also, but
yeah.
I don't know if I could play that game.
It's one of those, like, I have Dungeon Defenders 2, and it's pretty similar. And they finished Dungeon Defenders
like
2, so.
MOBA-type one coming out. It's called Orcs Must Die Unchained or something.
Yeah, it's that was be free at PAX. To play.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks interesting.
Competitive, you set up traps against each other. But yeah, Steam sales are always fun times. We'll report back next week what we'll pick up.
Right, Stardew Valley's on sale if you haven't picked it up for 20% off. I know Guido didn't like the game, but I still think that it's a pretty good game.
Oh, the Steam controller's on sale for 30% off.
Yeah,
it's like $35.
All on sale.
So if you want to, if you don't have a controller, you can get a Steam controller for $35.
If you want to see what a controller looks like, if like the unholy love child of a 360 controller and a trackpad. Then yeah, I just don't like it at all.
Is that thing a piece of garbage?
I don't know.
I've never used it.
I've heard mixed reviews about it, and I've held one as a sample at Micro Center, and it's two trackpads instead of joysticks. I mean, it's probably better in the long run or something, but I couldn't figure
not
it
fun.
Out.
I've heard people that like it and people that don't really like. It's just a different input, you know.
Yeah.
All right. Speedrunners is on sale as well.
Oh, Speedrunners? People
don't have it. Yeah, it's on 75% off.
Oh, damn, pick that up. Speedrunners
like
is a great game. That
it's a great game.
Play often enough. I'll play Speedrunners anytime.
It's a great pickup game if you only have a couple of minutes to do stuff.
Damn, that game's like $15 regularly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's worth it.
It's very good.
It's a really fun game. But it's on sale for $3.75.
Because I don't remember.
I got it in a Humble Bundle, I believe.
Yeah, that's.
I think I did too.
Because
when it first came out, it was in a Humble Bundle. But yeah, some pretty solid games I think out there. Just nothing that I'm gonna buy.
I don't have the desire to play anything outside of Overwatch or League right now.
Right. I don't have the time like to play those two games, and those are the two games that I really want to play right now. Oh, and I've been playing some more Zelda Ocarina whenever I get a chance.
Sweet. Sweet, sweet, sweet. I don't really want to get into this G2A thing.
I don't want to do that either. basically what they're saying is that G2A...
Dude, you don't have to give them a basically. Just forget it. Just don't even mention it.
I got to poop. But I got 10 minutes. So,
okay, see ya.
Okay, bye, Wally.
I got to go.
Bye
in
from
like
the
10
podcast
minutes.
That you actually are at.
Abandon our podcast.
Yeah.
The
oh
one
my
that
God.
You are a part of.
See okay, ya. Hold the poop in.
No, go poop. In. I don't want
go.
You here.
No,
I don't want poopy
not,
butt. I don't want poopy butt fucking Wally here.
For you. So, no, I'm going to sit right here and just poop and poop my pants.
Good.
Anyways.
Good.
All right, we'll just move on to listener of the week.
Yeah.
We're falling apart here. Oh, boy. I got to find the segue here. I wasn't prepared for this.
God, Torchlight 2 is $4, too?
Torchlight 2, I don't know.
I couldn't get into it. I know it's more of the same.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it's fine. It's a good game.
Yeah, it's all right.
If you want a dungeon crawler.
You own Diablo, though, so just play the better game.
Yeah.
Grim Dawn is good, too, if you're wanting to play something different action RPG wise.
What's this Dragon's Dogma? It's got so many good reviews, but
it's a port of a console, very popular console RPG that's actually kind of old now.
Oh,
and it's just
it?
An open world action RPG game.
Huh. Single player. One person.
Yeah, but
you can
like take on as lackeys other people's lackeys if you're friends with them or something. You have like followers that follow you around, and you can like exchange followers and stuff. But you're basically hunting monsters down, and like there's a plot, I think. But it's very Japanese.
All right, listener of the week, here it is.
Yo, listener of the week now, he's gonna be real sweet now.
Just listener of the week.
Yeah. This week's listener of the week is Master of Kool, a.k.a. Sweaty Heart. Master of Kool gave us 5 stars on iTunes, the United States of America iTunes. And he titled his review, "This is a new review, Nasty." Ooh, a little jab there, Nasty. How do you feel about that?
Jeez, fuck. I didn't know I fucked it up.
And his review is as follows. I love this podcast. At a comedy information ratio of 3-1, this is the perfect recipe for a delightful day. I'm also sober now. Wait, I'm also sober for now. I don't understand that last joke.
I'm
also sober, comma, for now.
Yeah, he and I drank a lot.
Oh.
A 24-hour stream.
Oh, this is a long time ago. That's why. This is a March review. Yeah. Okay, well, thanks, Master of Kool, a.k.a. Sweaty Heart, Discord regular. You are listener of the week.
Yo, listener of the week now, he's gonna be real sweet now.
Just listener of the week.
Yeah. You can be listener of the week by leaving a review on iTunes. Whatever iTunes you're part of, be it United States of America, Canada, Australia, United Kingdom, China, Somalia, whatever. It don't matter, baby.
I was going to see how long you were going to go.
Ness, you want to do some plugs?
Yeah, if you guys want to check us out on social media or anyplace else, go to justokgamers.com. If you guys want to support us and get your name below on the ticker in the videos, then go to patreon.com/justokgamers and become a patron. We have Patreon night tomorrow night. For those of you that are eligible to come, we would love to see your beautiful faces.
Yes, Patreon night, $10 and up, the tiers of $10 and up. We lock down some Discord channels and we play some video games.
Not so, with Wally.
Yeah, Wally is missed.
I missed two.
Yeah.
Yeah, I missed the last one, but I was there for the one before that.
Okie dokie. So yeah, everybody go to Patreon. Help us out. We appreciate it. Much appreciated. Show. We got 2 segues to do.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, 2 new segue guys.
Which is awesome. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Anything else?
Oh, I think I'm good.
Yeah? Mama good.
Mama good.
Oh, mama good. Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right. Yeah. Thanks for listening, guys. We'll catch you next time. And we'll see you on the other side. Peace.
Flip side.
And peace. Farewell.
Hmm.
Okay. We're done with the audio part of it. I am so orange right now.
You are. I don't know what happened. Like, you started auto-correcting in the middle of that.
Yeah, I don't know. So, how's chat doing? What's up, Black Nola? How's it going, buddy?
Hi, Nola.
Hey, Nola, I'll see you in L.A. in a few weeks, buddy. Yeah. Looking forward to it.
When I saw that, I was like, oh, did we make it? And then I was like, oh.
Are you guys bummed? I'm sorry. Like, I don't know.
I'm bummed.
I feel a little bit.
Like, but at the same time, it's just like.
You deserve it, though.
Right. Like, we don't make videos like you do. And the videos that we do make usually aren't for League. So,
Nola, I don't think that's NDA. NDA is what we're probably going to be doing there, but.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're more than welcome to be a guest on the show. Yeah.
Come back on the
show. Oh, yeah.
Next week if you want. Next Thursday. Yeah. We don't got to. Do we have someone? Tuesday. No, we don't. Tuesday. Oh, yeah, we're doing it Tuesday.
Tuesday.
So yeah, if you got nothing to do next Tuesday night, you're more than welcome. Golgi, thanks for sticking around for the whole show.
Yeah, thanks, Golgothis. Pyro.
How is the guest? Was the guest all right? It ran long.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out what you wanted to do with it.
No, I didn't see it coming. No, not the minute you dropped that punchline, then I got it.
That was good.
Yeah.
I don't know. How did you think it went?
Yeah, it went long. I wish you, I don't know. The whole stork thing we probably didn't need to do. Just like alluding, like we're going to tell you. You should probably just got onto it and then move on from there.
Yeah.
Well, we just wanted your money.
Yeah, that's
right.
Yeah, we wanted the money.
Get the money.
Yeah, take the money and run.
Yeah. It was a fun guest. It was all right.
Yeah, I had fun with him.
We'll know better for next time.
Yeah.
Better for next time.
Yeah. It's been a while since we've had a guest.
Been a while. Yeah, who's the last one? It was probably Vince.
Yeah.
I mean, guest.
Yeah, like. No, but yeah, I think that is probably who the last guest was.
Right.
Man, I haven't played Stardew Valley in a while.
Kenny? Who's Kenny? Golgothis. What? Stardew Valley? Oh, yeah. No, we're talking about guests, not actual real people.
Yeah, not actual guests.
Sorry. I need to get my vape in and wet my throat.
I'm going to make the keyword phrase Dr. Richard Plunkett. Yeah. So hopefully we can SEO it up enough that when
overtake
people search
him?
The real doctor, yeah.
Then we actually like
or if
him.
They're looking for him, then
oh, it's
podcast.
An interview with my general practitioner, of course.
Yeah, of course I want to see how he is.
Oh, dear God, no!
Also, I kept dropping that I was a doctor. I was waiting for you guys because I didn't want to burn.
I asked you right.
You asked me right off the bat, and I didn't want to burn that I was a fucking OBGYN before I asked what the fucking mystery was. I guess I should have given you guys some more prep, probably.
Yeah, you gave us like zero heads up of like where you wanted to take it.
Yeah, but I wanted to see where you guys would take it too.
Well, we did what we always do. We took it on a fucking train wreck.
yeah.
It was a fun show, though.
Yeah, it was fun.
I had a lot of fun.
Wally's got to go do another podcast. I hope he talks more on it than he does on ours.
Yeah.
What time is it? Oh, it's 9.
9 o'clock?
It's not even 9.
It's
not
even late. We got done early this week.
It's an hour and 17 minutes.
We started on time, though, kind of. That's why.
Right. And
like we were rolling on time. Like, we had podcasts coming soon at 7.
Yeah. Cool. All right. Well, we'll put this up on iTunes.
Yeah.
Thank you, as always, for the small live stream audience. Eventually, we'll get more people for you guys to talk to. Golg, I saw you holding it down in chat.
Yeah, thank you. Sweet little community, though. And a lot of you guys are on Discord anyways, but if you're not, that's where the chat continues.
Yeah, we always are on there every single day. I say good morning to everybody. At least I try to every single day.
Yep.
And then I don't talk to anybody forever. Until the next morning.
So yeah, Pyro.
It's just been crazy.
Pyro, are you not on Discord? Because I tried to give you your tag, your Patreon tag, but yeah, I didn't see you. So get on that Discord.
Yeah, get in here. Get in here. Yeah, it also didn't help that I was super late on the dock this week. My bad, guys.
It's all good. Yeah, we went into this podcast with not a much
on the dock.
There wasn't that much though to talk about.
Well, true, Pyro, true. Like, Discord's half text chat. Like, the Patreon, yeah. Which I guess it wouldn't.
He can get in the Patreon chat channel.
Yeah, he could. Yeah, that's the a whole thing of it. But, like, it's mostly text chat, I'd say.
Yeah, I'd say I'm on there more texting than I am talking.
Right. Which, like, is something we should probably mention to people. Like, there's a few Patreon people that don't have Discord yet. So.
Yeah, I didn't even think about that. I kind of just assumed. We talked about it a little bit, I think, when we first got it, but I don't think that we really talked about it much since. About the fact that it's text and voice.
Cool. Well, I think that's it, boys. We're out of here.
Yeah, we're out. Up.
Does your tum-tum feel better? Oh, he gone. Oh, he just shut down his camera. Tum-tum feel better? Oh, is he here? No.
I'm here. I'm here. Oh, I feel better.
Good.
And now I'm gone.
What is this, a four-man circle jerk? It sure is.
It is, and you just missed it.
And you just missed it. Yep, the circle jerk is over.
All right, everybody. Bye-bye. The cameras are all messed up, so we'll see ya.
Thanks for coming, guys. Everybody.
Thanks for watching.